Good morning, and welcome to Free Spirit Ministerial Worship Center. Bishop Timothy Byron McGee and Pastor Bernadine Bell McGee are honored to have you worship with them at 16012 Cottage Grove in South Holland, Illinois. Free Spirit Ministerial Worship Center is where we believe Jesus is Lord, building His kingdom is our purpose, and every guest or member is our priority. We are Free Spirit Ministerial Worship Center, where our motto is inspiring ordinary people to do extraordinary things. Wherever you are online, join, like, follow, and share Free Spirit Ministerial Worship Center. We can be found on Facebook and YouTube. Now, let's enter into our worship.
Wherever you at, just say, I serve a big God. Come on, say, I serve a big God. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together like this. Come on.
Yeah.
you know he goes beyond your wildest dreams, somebody give God a praise this morning. If you believe he's able to do the impossible, somebody give God a big praise this morning. Yeah. Bless your name, Jesus. He can do it. He can handle it. He can turn it. He can make a way. He can fix it. Somebody say, there's nothing my God cannot do. Yeah.
If you would stand, it is time. I'm so excited about the word of God. Free spirit, let's act like we flew this man of God in. Put your hands together as we receive. Teacher, apostle, Willis, Collins. Come on.
Well, come on, give Jesus a good hand clap. Hallelujah. Well, the Lord is good, isn't he? Yes, 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 yes. We thank God for everything that he's doing and what he's going to do. We couldn't do it without him. I truly thank God for my bishop that's away right now. We just believe God for his safe return in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. And I just pray that he's having a wonderful, wonderful time where he is. And again, I thank God for our pastor. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We're going to get right into the word of the Lord. Father, we thank you. We praise you for today. Holy Spirit, I need you. Can't do it without you. Have your way. Have your way. You are the greatest teacher in all the universe. So I trust you to speak to me and speak through me. In the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, you can be seated in his presence. Hallelujah. St. Matthew chapter 11, a very familiar scripture, but I want to just go in a whole different direction if I can today by the Spirit of God. St. Matthew? Yeah. St. Mark, forgive me. St. Mark chapter 11, verse 22 and 23. It says, and Jesus answering saith unto them, have faith in God, not in yourself, not in your degrees and all of that, not in your businesses and nothing's wrong. But he says, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that's his way of saying, because if you do, this is the results that you will get. That whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Then the 23rd verse says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them, and what will happen? You shall have them. I want to read that again. He says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and ye shall have them. So I want to just share with you on the faith that prevails. The faith that prevails. Now, what I want to bring out and emphasize today is in this faith and the teaching that we're going to get into today, I'm going to be talking about the process of faith. Now, we hear a lot about the workings of faith. and what faith will do if you use it. But I want to talk about the process of faith, which consists of the just shall live by faith, and the scripture says we walk by faith and not by sight. So I want to talk about how to walk it out. How to walk it out. We know how to use it, but do you know how to live it? We have seen the workings of faith, but have you experienced the lifestyle of faith? Just shout at me, walk it out. Oh, now I want to say some things that it seems is going to mess up your faith ideologies. Did I say that right? But y'all got the point, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But it's going to help you. Everything is not going to happen overnight. Shall walk it out. So let's just establish that. Some things take time. Come on, y'all. But what I want you to get is learn how to stand when it seems that you have no platform to stand on, no ground to stand on, nothing to hold on to. Hello, somebody. The faith that prevails. Faith that persists. It's persistent, that kind of faith, that have decided that if God said it, I'm going to hold on to it, even though everything around me says it's not going to happen. Where did we get the idea from that when you believe God, it's going to be right there? And what happens is the devil uses that against us and tell you, oh, see, that faith stuff don't work. What's the use of you praying? That don't work. Because you're thinking that if I say it right now, it's going to happen right now. Now, when I was, you know, getting this together, and you all helped me. I know you theologians and everything. So if I miss a couple of tits and tats and tanks and tears, it's you know, charge it to my head and not my heart. But all of a sudden, I get these two words, Pastor, Chronos and Kairos. I'm like, I had to ask Siri to spell it for me. So when I get into this Chronos and Kairos, and I look it up, and of course, you know, they got some deep stuff, deep stuff. So I said, now, Holy Spirit, would you kind of help bring this down to my level so that I can understand it and I'll be able to explain it so that the people will get it? Because, see, I'm not trying to sound deep. That's just a waste of time to me. Okay? So when I get this, I'm thinking about this faith that prevails, and then I'm thinking about this Chronos and Kairos. I find out that Kairos is what has already been before it happens. Kairos is what has already happened before it happens. Okay? Chronos is when Kairos is here. Chronos time brings what Kairos has predestinated to where you are manifested. Did I say that good? Did y'all get that? I hope so, because I don't know if I can say it again. So I begin to think about predestination. God in his world has already planned your world. He's in Kairos, you in Kronos, and now when Kronos kiss Kairos, y'all give birth. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, help me. So that's where faith comes in. Say, walk it out. Everything is not going to happen right then. Even when a woman gets pregnant, she don't have the baby the next day. Remember when God said to Jeremiah, before you was in your mother's womb, Kairos, I knew you. And then his mom and daddy got together in Kronos and called Kronos into Kairos, and there he was. So when you get with God by faith and begin to walk this thing out, while you're walking with God, something is being developed. Oh, but you got to walk it out. Say, walk it out. Don't let the devil tell you that if you can't see it the moment you say it, you don't have it. What do you think Paul meant? Not much of this is in my notes, so I'm just going to flow with this. Can I just do that? What did you think Paul meant when Paul wrote to the Ephesians church that the Spirit of God says, I bless you with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus? If he bless you with all, what you looking for? If he done bless you with all, huh? All in Kairos. Your faith brings what's in Kairos all into Kronos now. But you gotta walk it, shall walk it out. Oh, I like it when y'all say that. Say it again for me. Make me feel good. Walk it out. Walk it out. Walk it out. You're gonna go through some challenges, but walk it out. You're gonna go through some things that gonna hurt your feelings, but walk it out, girl. You're gonna experience some stuff that you're not gonna like. Walk it out. Everything is not gonna go your way, but the enemy is gonna fight you every step of the way, but what? Oh yeah. Notice what Jesus said. He said, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. Believe that you receive them and you shall have them. So you got to, that's what walking this thing out is. You got to believe that it's yours and you got it before you get it. Because believing that you have it is what brings it into manifestation. Say, walk it out. Walk it out. That's why you cannot afford to go by what you see. You cannot afford to go by how you feel. You got to walk it out. What did God say? This faith that prevails is persistent. It's resilient faith. It's faith that does not give up or quit until the desired answer come. Remember the story of Daniel? Remember Daniel? And oh God. Remember when he prayed and the answer came 21 days? Was that Daniel? Okay. 21 days, the answer came, right? No, the answer came the first day he prayed. Because the scripture said, when the angel got to Daniel, said, the day that you set your heart to seek God, I heard you and the answer was released. But the Kairos had to connect. Y'all get that? So Daniel had to walk it out. Daniel had to walk it out. Just like you and I have to walk it out. When things don't look good, you got to walk it out. When things don't go right, you got to walk it out. Because he said, what things soever you desire when you pray, you got to believe that you receive it before you get it, and then you have it. Walk it out. Walk it out. You don't give up until you get the desired results. You have to get your mind off of time and get your mind on God. Because whenever you talk about God and faith, it is always right now. God is always is. Did y'all get that? I said, God is always is. Faith is always is. It's always present tense. What we have to learn how to do is get it from where it is to where we want it to be. Remember when God said, let there be light? That was not the creation of light. That was bringing it from where it was to where I want it to be. What was in Kairos, God wanted it in Chronos. So he said, let there be light. Can I bring another point out to you? Now, if light comes from the sun, what did God mean the first day when he said, let there be light, and the sun wasn't created till the fourth day? So evidently, that let there be light must have meant something other than daylight. God's number one plan, God's number one thought, if you would, is purpose. When God said, let there be light, the first time, he was talking about enlightenment, illumination, purpose. Things was out of order. So if you ever want to set stuff in order, you got to give it its purpose. You got to give it its purpose. He said, this is not the way it's supposed to be. So he called forth the waters and he was giving it purpose. And then he began to set everything. So when you speak in God's word, that's what you're doing. You're giving its purpose. You're giving it its purpose. When you discover purpose, then you can set things in order. You can't set stuff in order if you don't know the purpose of it. If you don't know the purpose of a car, you can do anything but drive. Because you don't know that's why they was created. Come on, y'all. When you don't know the purpose of a person, you misuse them. The reason people have problems with church and preachers, because they don't know the purpose of them. So, because they don't know the purpose of a church, and they don't know the purpose of a preacher, they misuse them. And you try to get something from them that God never put in them to give you. Shout, walk it out. Oh, God. Some of the stuff that we're expecting. I know this may be, seem like I'm going off a little, but here I go. Some of the stuff that we may be expecting from our leaders never was put in them to give you. What you're trying to get from them is what you should be getting from God. Leaders don't establish relationship. They feed you and show you the purpose so you can have your own. That's why it's unfortunate and it does not work for you when you try to build your life on your leader's faith. Oh, Lord. Without having a relationship with God for yourself. So then, when your leader, whatever the case may be, miss it or fall just like you do, now you want to leave God. You didn't have God in the first place. Because if you did, you would understand that my relationship is what got me here. Not my relationship with them, but my relationship with God. Come on, shout, walk it out. When I'm just using this as an example, Pastor shared and brought it out. You can edit this out if you want to. When Bishop talked to me, and we talked about me coming here to Free Spirit, he wasn't the only one that reached out to me. There were others that wanted me to come. But because in this case, I heard from God. Now, I'm not trying to sound spiritual. I'm just saying what it is. So I heard from God. So the others offered more. They offered more. They offered some stuff. That's why faith is not about stuff. Because if you build it on stuff, if you build it on stuff, you're not going to last in times of trouble. Because we all know that all this stuff we got don't mean nothing now. Ain't helping none of us. We all these expensive shoes and cars and big old churches and all, ain't helping none of us because Corona showed us who really got the power. All right, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I know church folk don't like being real. See, where you put your faith, I'm talking about people in general that do that. They put their faith in their church or they put their faith in their, all in their leader. And your leader was staying home just like you was. The mega church's doors was closed just like the little one on the corner. Come on, y'all. Shout, walk it out. Okay, I'm going to go from there because I know we don't like being real. The church world, you know. So here, this resilient, this persistent faith, this faith that don't give up and don't quit. In spite of how it looks, in spite of what we may be experiencing, there are some things that you just gonna have to grow into. All right. Come on, y'all here? I said there are some things you just gonna have to grow into. Oh, yeah. Hello. Are you praying before you get here? Are you fasting other than when Bishop say let's fast on Thursday? What is your walk with God like? Are you basing it on other things? Some stuff, again, we're just going to have to grow into. So it's not going to take place overnight. It's not going to happen overnight. So stop beating yourself up and allowing the enemy to beat you up over stuff that you have no control over. I don't care if I can use the Brother Darryl, how old is your son?
10.
I'm use that as an example. He's 10. I don't care how bad he may want to be 17. It ain't going to happen till he get past 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, then 17. I don't care how bad you may want to be whoever or whatever you may want to be. You got to walk this thing out. Amen. You're not going to be. Stop using other people as measuring rods for you. Because you don't know what their life is like. You don't know what they've been through. Hello, y'all. You probably don't even want to go through some of the stuff that some of these people have gone through to be where they are in God. I know I don't. That's why you cannot afford to allow people to define you. No one knows the value of a thing other than the manufacturer. No one. So nobody can put their value on you because they didn't create you. Not only that, don't allow anybody to disqualify you that did not die for you. Walk it out. Now we all familiar with Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11 and 1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Right? It is the substance of things what? The substance of things hoped for. It is the substance of things hoped for. Shout hope. It is the substance of things hoped for. It is the substance of things hoped for. So where there is no hope, there can be no faith. I said, now, faith is now, hope is future. So, hope must kiss faith for a manifestation. But if you have no hope, you have nothing for faith to give substance to. So, if you're not dreaming, if you're not expecting, you can't give birth to something that you're not expecting. Come on, y'all. Talking about this faith that prevails. This faith that prevails. Notice in St. Mark chapter 4. St. Mark chapter 4. Here. I'm not going to read all of them, but from verse 26 to 32, I'm going to jump down because the verse 32, I believe it says, wherefore shall we liken the kingdom of God? Or with what comparison shall we compare it? Then he said, it is like the grain of a mustard seed, which when it is sown in the earth, is less than all the seeds that be in the earth. But when it is sown, shooteth out great branches, so that the fowls of the air may lodge under the shadow of it. Now, in that same, those verses, it talks about, for the earth bringeth forth fruit of itself. Then it gives you the different stages. First, the blade. First, the blade. Say, walk it out. First, the blade. You don't plant a seed today and go and pick off fruit tomorrow. First, the blade. When you put a seed, there's some things that have to happen in that seed in order for it to produce fruit. And the first thing it has to do is got to be buried. Next, this is the part that church folk don't like. It's got to die. Nobody wants to die. I want what I want. The way I want it. When I want it. It has to die. Everything you could ever want is in the seed. In that seed is a tree. And on that seed are branches. And at the end of those branches are fruit. But they don't come all at the same time. That's first the blade. They don't look too pretty. Now, you think the blade is kind of, you dig it up and look at what you done planted after you done planted it a while. You think, oh, nothing could come out of this. Nothing could come out of this. Remember in Revelations where John says that he said, and they overcame him. But I know that's, yeah, come on, quote it from that's y'all's favorite scripture. They overcame him by the, come on, talk to me. Don't be scared. They overcame him how? And what else? All right, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. But you know which part they miss? The end says, and they love not their life unto death. One reason that a lot of people are not producing, they're too in love with themselves. They're too in love with what they want. Come on, y'all. He says, first the blade, then the ear comes the fruit. And then we harvest. Stop trying to harvest before you ever bury it. We really got quiet on that one, didn't we? I said, stop trying to harvest before you even bury it. Before you can ever harvest, you got to bury the seed. You got to speak it. You got to continue to speak over it. That's watering it. Every time you speak the word, you're watering the seed that you plant. But before we get to watering it, plant it. Plant it. And in the process of time, all things being equal, it's going to produce. But you can't give up and quit just because you can't go out tomorrow morning and pick off an apple or whatever it is. You got to give it time. Process. We don't like process. Because, you know, we want it now. You know, we don't like the process. We give leniences for us. But everybody else, I don't understand. What taking them so long? Why they ain't got it yet? I don't understand. How long they been saved? Now you've been saved 20 years and you just now learned one thing. Now all of a sudden you judging everybody else. Hello.
Come on.
Because it's a process. Everybody don't grow the same way. All of your children don't grow the same way. All of mine didn't grow the same way. Everybody, all of yours ain't growing the same. You didn't grow the same way some of your siblings did. Because some of your siblings looked at you like, what's wrong with her? They wanted to go to their mom and dad. Now if there's anybody in here named, well, I better not call that name because it sounds too familiar. Yeah, if anybody in here named Mary Jane, I'm not talking about you, Mary. But they be like, Mama, is Mary a little slow? Because Mary ain't producing like maybe John did. Everybody, you know, it's the process is different for everybody. So I can't talk about your faith.
Hallelujah.
Because God is taking you away that he may not be taking me. You can't talk about somebody else's because God ain't taking you the way that all of us can't handle the same. Come on, y'all. All of us cannot handle the same thing. I don't know. Now, you know, I'm still growing. I don't know if I could withstand and handle the stuff that elder have gone through.
Amen.
I don't know if I can.
That's right.
Or some of the stuff that you may or you or you or whoever. And so since God knows that too,
Amen.
He don't put on me or allow to come against me what he allowed to come against some others. Because he know what you can take. He know what we can take and what we can't take. He knows, and if he allow it to come, that's because he done put something in you. He put that treasure, Lord have mercy. He put a treasure in an earthen vessel. That's like taking a diamond and putting it in the garbage can. God took his treasure and put it in you. Now, in the natural, we've said, boy, how messed up that is. But God believes in you. I say, God believes in you. He knows what you can handle because he don't want to put it in there. He has more confidence in you than you got in yourself. He said quite often to the disciples, O ye of little faith, but it didn't stop them from becoming apostles. It didn't stop them from being used. Some of the greatest miracles we know of was worked by the apostles after the day of Pentecost. Them same men that Jesus kept saying, where is your faith? Oh, ye of little faith. Because through the process of time, they developed. They got stronger. They could handle more. After the day of Pentecost, something took place in them that turned them into another person. And it'll do the same for us. It'll do the same for us. Amen.
Amen.
And they grew and they grew and they grew just like we grow and grow and grow. And as we do, we learn, I'm closing, we learn to handle the storms better. We learn how to handle the storms better. That's the reason that the scripture talks about us as eagles. Because God put, as it were, like an eagle spirit in us. You can handle more than you think. I said, you can handle more than you think. You just need to get out of yourself.
and start looking at what he said. Hello. And you know what I'm happy about? I'm truly, truly glad that it has nothing to do with my inabilities or yours. Hello. I don't understand why God used crazy people. I don't get it. How he could take somebody that's all messed up. And then use them in ways that astounds the world. And everybody that they come in contact with. I believe that he wants them to know, wants me to know, wants you to know that it is not you. So at the end, no flesh will glory in his sight. No flesh will glory in his sight. You can look all through the scripture from Adam all the way to Revelations and you'll see. Them prophets was kind of, something was wrong with some of them. It was some serious stuff wrong with David. Huh? It was some, anybody that's got 700 wives and 800 concubines and they call him the man of wisdom. Something wrong with, hello y'all. You know, we read Proverbs, is it Proverbs 30 about the 31, the virtuous woman. 31, we read about the virtuous woman. And we talk about how wise Solomon was. Proverbs 31 was Solomon's mama telling Solomon, you crazy. You crazy. All them women. You need a virtuous woman. That was his mother talking to him. Just walk it out. Walk it out. Time. Don't be afraid. Where you are today is not where you're going to be tomorrow. Where you are today is not where you were yesterday or last week or last month. It may not seem like you got better. It may not seem like you're stronger. But every day you wake up and make it to the end, that's because God done put something in you that you didn't know was there. So walk it out. He's put in you what you need. Don't stop trying to be other folks. That's one of the problems that... Jesus is our example. Not this church or that church or that preacher or this preacher. Or not. Jesus is our example. And the more we strive to be like him, the greater we become in him. That's the greater we become in him, the more we strive to be like him. Father, we thank you. We praise you for your word. Thank you for all that you've done and what you're doing. And what you're going to do. We know that the best is yet to come. That we are not even close. Have not even seen all of what you have for us. And where you're going to take us and what you're going to do in us and through us. So we thank you. We praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Come on, give Jesus a praise. Come on, give Jesus praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Y'all know what? Y'all need to stand up. Amen. And in justice word, come on. Woo! Have been filled and fed. Come on, let's just stand up and give him praise. Come on, Let's receive the word of God with gladness. Woo, my God in heaven. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus on the main line. Thank you for the word today. Come on, praise and put a praise on that word. Yes, God. Come on, let's just worship for a moment. Let's worship so the word can go down. Come on. Some of us have to die. We have to die daily so that the word of God can take good root. Thank you, Lord, for the word. Glory to God. We give you praise for the word. We respect the word today. This man of God ministered. Bless the Lord. I just text somebody. I said, you should have been at church today. Glory to God. We thank God, Apostle, for the word of God. We release great blessings and divine, amen, favor your way. Thank God for the man of God. We pray, Lord, that you would bless him exclusively, significantly, abundantly. Let the word of God that he spoke to us, God, return 100-fold on his behalf in Jesus' name. It is so, so it is. Give God praise for the word of God. Thank you, Lord. Somebody that don't know the Lord, you can get past your past and your pain. You can walk it out. Rome was never built in a day. Come on, he wants to kiss your Kairos and your Chronos together. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I don't care what you've done, how long you've done it, who you've done it with. Oh, bye. He wants to reunite himself with you. He's the best thing that can ever happen to you. If you're looking, streaming, wherever you are in the virtual sanctuary, in the literal sanctuary, maybe you're in a backslidden condition, maybe you just need some prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus. If it is you, you can stand. You can, even if you're in the literal sanctuary, you can come to the altar. Amen. We're not going to slay you. We're just going to pray over you in Jesus' name with your mask on. Look like you can't get past some things, but we're going to walk this out. The word of God have come. Come on, brother. Yes, it's all right. Let's not forget the altar is good. Yes, come on. Thank you, Lord. Some of us, yes, brother. Thank you, Lord. Yes, you got to live your life. Glory to Jesus. We're going to walk it out. What that means is step by step, a righteous man will fall 7 times, but he will not be utterly destroyed. I bind the enemy of condemnation, make you feel like you can't do this. No, you can't do it, but Chronos and Kairos has already, amen, been implemented. And come on, Chronos is going to catch up and it's going to manifest. Yes. I'm going to ask one of the brothers, amen, our elder to pray with him. Brother, God loves you. Just you, whoever, if you repeat after me, if, amen, if you are streaming live, ask God, Father, forgive me of my sins. I don't care how sinful you are. God loves you. He's able to help you walk day by day. And I want you to know, amen, if you repeat, Father, forgive me of my sins, I repent and I ask you to come into my heart according to the word of God. If I confess my sins, you're faithful to forgive my sins. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, if I mean it and I say it, God, reverently. I say it, Father, and I ask you to come in and wash me from all uncleanliness and let me walk this salvation walk out every day. Father, I believe that you died and rose again on the third day. And if you said that prayer and believed that in your heart and was genuine, you are not saved and you are a candidate, amen, and for heaven. You are, amen, a born-again Christian, and we welcome you into the, amen, the kingdom, amen, citizenship family. Amen. If you are without a church family, amen, we appreciate you looking, streaming. Amen. Free Spirit Ministerial Worship Center, 16012 South Cottage Grove is a great place to visit, but amen, even a better place to belong. Feel free to come hang out with us. We are back in the sanctuary every Sunday, amen, at 8:45. Amen. God, there's a word like the word today that will meet you at the point of your needs. Amen. We love you. God bless you in Jesus' name. name. Come on, let's give God praise for, amen, salvation, for the word, for reconciliation, for restoration. Bless the name of the Lord. I'm living my life, amen, in this place. I'm gonna live my life even in a pandemic. I'm gonna live my life. Thank you, Lord. I'm not gonna die, amen, before time, in Jesus' name. Amen. God is good. Did we not enjoy the word of God today? Did not we receive it? We didn't just enjoy it, we received it. Glory to God. Y'all go ahead and give. Four ways to give. Y'all got Giblify, you got Zelle, you got Cash App, and you got, amen, if you mail it in, and certainly some of you, amen, you mail it in, or you just put it in the hands, amen, of the administrator or Bishop McGee. So let's stand, amen, in the house of the Lord, and let's give your tithe and your offerings. Amen. Thank God for you. Get ready. Amen. We're going to bless and hold your devices up, standing in the presence of the Lord. Father, we thank you for the devices that represent, Father God, integral giving. We thank you, Lord, for every tither, every offertory, Father, that's coming our way. We pray, Father, that you would bless, Father God, every giving spirit, every giver, as we walk it out. And God, faith without works is dead. So we work as we sow. Bless it, press it down, shake it together, give it back to us in the form of our needs, 30, 60, and even 100-fold. We decree even 100-fold blessings back to every integral giver in Jesus' name. It is so, so it is in Jesus' name. Give God praise. Thank you. Amen. Send your offering.
Come on, walk on this real quick.